CIET NCERT presents curriculum based series Dhwani Shala. So friends, let's join in Dhwani Shala class 4.
Hello, myself Siddharth. Today we are going to discuss chapter number 2 of class 4, Maths Magic. It is an NCERT textbook for class 4. Chapter name is Long and Short. I hope you will enjoy and feel connected while listening to this program. Before starting the chapter, do you want to listen a story? Very good. I know you all are very eager to listen to stories. We all love stories. So without wasting time, let's start the story. Children, have you heard about Akbar and Birbal? Yes, you are correct. Akbar was a great king and Birbal was his smartest minister. Akbar has many ministers and Birbal was one of the smartest ministers with Akbar. One day, Akbar drew a line on floor and asked his all ministers to make that line shorter. He drew a line on floor and want his minister to make that line shorter. This looks very simple. Yes or no? Anyone can do this? We can erase the line and make it shorter. All his minister also said, erase the line or cut the line. They said, we can erase the line or we can cut the line to make it shorter. But Akbar said, no, you could not cut or erase the line. Without erasing the line, you have to make it shorter. Initially, it looks very simple. But now, it had become very difficult. How can we shorten a line without erasing or cutting it? It is a very tough question for us and for his minister also. All ministers said, it is impossible. But Birbal was silent. Birbal was thinking something. Seeing this, Akbar went towards Birbal and said to him. What he said? He said, you are my smartest minister. You two couldn't solve this problem. Then Birbal thought for a while and he stood up. Something was going through his mind. He was thinking something. Can you guess? what was he thinking? Do you know what he does? He drew a new line near Akbar's line. Line drawn by Birbal was much longer than Akbar's line. Now, there are two lines on the floor. One drawn by Akbar and another one drawn by Birbal. When they compared the lines, line drawn by Birbal was longer and line drawn by Akbar was shorter. Birbal has not cut or erased Akbar's line, but he drew a longer line. So Akbar's line becomes shorter in comparison to new line. I know you all are very smart, like Birbal. Can you answer my questions? Come on, I know you can do it. So be ready. Please tell me, how many fingers do we have in one hand? Raise your one hand and count the finger. Yes, you are right. We have 5 fingers. Now, can you tell me which finger is longest? Yes, you are correct. Our middle finger is longest. It is a very easy question, hai na? Now, I have a difficult question to you. Can you make your middle finger shorter? Yes, you heard this right. Can you make your middle finger shorter? Yes, you are right, children. I know you all are smarter than Birbal. You have solved my problem. Yes, you all are right. When you compare your finger with elders like your father, your mother, or grandparents, your middle finger becomes shorter in comparison to their finger. I already said, you are very smart. Can you guess the length of your middle finger? How many centimeter is it? Come on. You only have to guess. In my school, I have students of your age. If I imagine those students, I can say it will be around 6 centimeters. Children, do you have a pencil or pen with you? Can you guess its length? How many centimeters is it? Right now, I have a pencil with me. If I have to guess its length, I will say it will be around 12 centimeters long. I have lots of questions today. I know you will answer all my questions. So let's start. Can you guess the length of tube light? Yes, tube light which gives us light. Tube light on the wall. What will be the length of it? Is it more than 100 centimeters or less? Think, student, what is the length of tube light? I think it will be around 120 centimeters. Yes, I know you two have guessed the same. Now, can you guess the height of your mother and father? No, you don't have to measure them right now. Just guess their height. How tall are they? When you go to college, after completing your schooling, you will also become taller. Now tell me, who is tallest in your family? Who is tallest? It may be your mother or father or someone else. Do you know the tallest man on earth? The tallest man on earth is Sultan. He is 251 centimeters tall. He is very tall. 251 centimeter. 251 centimeters. Children, just imagine that you are standing next to him. How you feel? Do you want to ask him something? Note down in your notebook. Now tell me, if by chance he comes to your home, can he pass through the door without bending? Will he touch the roof of your house if he stands straight? Yes, my dear children, he is very tall. He cannot enter the house without bending. He has to bend to enter a room or enter a house. He needs a special door and a special bed too. Children, do you remember that 100 centimeters makes 1 meter? I know you all remember that 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeters. If we join 100 centimeters together, we get 1 meter. Have you noticed that? A scale in your geometry box, it is 15 centimeter long. Can you tell me how many such scales do you need to make 1 meter? Yes, children, we need 7 such scales. In one scale, we have 15 centimeter. If you take 2 scales, we will get 15 plus 15, 30 centimeter. In 3 scale, we will get 45 centimeter. Using 4 scale, we can reach 60 centimeter. And if we add 5th scale, we can reach 75 centimeter. And if we take one more scale, it means if we use 6 scales in all, we will reach 90 centimeter. For making it 100, we need one more scale. So we need 7 scale. By joining 7 scales, we will get 105 centimeter. It is more than 1 meter, exactly 5 centimeters more than 1 meter. Now, can you tell me how many centimeters will make half meter? In 1 meter, we have 100 centimeters. Then half meter must have, yes children, you are absolutely correct. There are 50 centimeters in half meter. You all are very intelligent. Okay children, now we will take one more example. It is about a race. Have you participated in a race? We should actively participate in race or in any sports or in athletics. My example is about a race of 100 meters. In this race, participant have to run 100 meters to finish the race. One girl named Arundhati is near to the finishing line. She is about 6 meters from it. Can you tell me how much distance she has covered? Yes, you are right. She has covered 94 meters. Yes, 94 plus 6 will be 100. After running 6 meters more, she will reach to finishing line. Behind Arundhati is Rehana. She is 10 meters behind Arundhati. Arundhati, who is at 94 meters, and Rehana is 10 meters behind her. Can you tell me how much distance Rehana has covered? Arundhati has covered 94 meters and Rehana is 10 meters behind her. So tell me, how much distance is covered by Rehana? Yes, my children, Rehana has covered 84 meters. See, Arundhati is at 94 meters and Rehana is 10 meters behind her. So she must be at 84, which we get after subtracting 10 meter from 94 meters. Now tell me, How far is Rihanna from finishing line? She is at 84 meters. She has to cover 100 meters in total. To reach finishing line, she have to run 100 meters. And currently, she is at 84 meters. So how much more she will run to reach finishing line? Are you thinking? Oh yes, some of you are doing it. You all are right. She has to run 16 meters more to reach finishing line at 100 meters. Currently, she is at 84 meters. She will reach 100 meters by running 60 meters more. Do you know? Once I asked the same question in my class. Almost all students gave correct answer. Then I asked how they reached to this answer. What they think before concluding 16 as answer. To my surprise, they gave different explanation of same answer. They all have given correct answer, but to reach this answer, they think differently. They had used different method and different calculation to give same answer. Some said she is at 84 meter. For reaching 90, she will run for 6 meters. And after reaching 90, she will run 10 meters more to reach 100. So, 6 to reach 90, and after that, 10 to reach 100. Hence, she will run 6 plus 10, that is 16 meters to complete the race. One of my students said, currently she is at 84. First we add 10, so she will be at 94. After that, we will add 6 to complete 100. So, she should run 6 meters plus 10 meters, that is 16 meters more to complete 100. One of my students said, we can subtract 84 from 100 and thus we can get the answer 16. So, she should run 16 meters more to complete 100 meters. Some students also said, she is at 84. If we add 1, we get 85, and 85 plus 5, 90, and 90 plus 10 will be 100. So 1 plus 5 plus 10, we get 16. So she should run 16 more meters to reach to finishing line. Some also drew number line. Some counted with pen and paper. So have you noticed? They were thinking differently, but reaching to same conclusion, same answer. So it is possible that there will be many ways to think and solve, and all ways are correct. I have one more question for you. Sheena was at 72 meters. How much distance she had to cover more to reach finishing line, which is at 100 meters? Yes, my dear student, you all are right. She will run 28 meters more to complete 100 meter. I know you all have thought differently. All of you are absolutely correct. Some of you may have subtracted 72 from 100. Some may have drawn number line. Some student have added 72 plus 8 to reach 80 and then 20 to reach 100. So 8 plus 20, that is 28. She has to run 28 meters to reach finishing line. Some may also have done 72 plus 10, 82. 82 plus 10, 92. And 92 plus 8, 100. So she should run 10 plus 10 plus 8. That is 28 meters more to reach finishing line. Some may be thinking 72 plus 3 is 75. And if we add 25 to 75, we will reach 100. So 3 plus 25, that is 28. 28 meters more to reach 100 meters. Some students may have thought differently. They all are right. You all are wonderful. I hope you enjoy the program. So, it is time to note down some homework. In first activity, guess your height. First, you have to guess your height, and after that, with the help of elders, measure your height. Children, first you have to guess about your height, and after that, you can measure your height and see the difference. See the difference between your guess and actual measurement. In second activity, trace your hand's finger on paper and measure the length of fingers using scale. In third activity, guess the length of following objects. First, you have to make a guess. Pencil box, pencil, your table, and length of your maths book. First, guess the length of these objects and note down in notebook. After guessing the length, measure their length by a ruler or scale. Then find out how accurate you are in guessing their lengths. Okay, student, bye-bye. We will meet again. I hope you enjoy the program. I miss you all.
So friends, you were just listening to the series Dhwani Shala. Production assistants Meenakshi Kukreti and Tanu Gupta. Recorded by Shanu Muksim and Vikas Sangwan. Produced by Ajit Horo. This program is brought to you by CIET NCERT, New Delhi, India.